The recommendations in that policy brief are a courageous attempt to strengthen the human rights-based approach to HIV policies and programs. The document calls for concerted action with other actors in society. And I feel this is very important. The key strategy is form coalitions, find allies, engage with other actors at the most diverse levels. I would like to quote one of the recommendations because it summarizes so concisely this thinking. And I quote, a collaborative effort in partnership with global health and development bodies, human rights bodies, and legal institutions is necessary to identify and repeal existing criminal laws and other policies targeting LGBT communities. A collaborative effort. I couldn't agree more. And in fact, I think that is the message that I want to stress in these few words I'm saying. I'm not saying that it is easy to do that. We all might overlook potential allies. We see that in our own practice as a development organization. We often fall back on the same circle of those we know and trust, and that's only human. But I think that we do need to look further. We need to take a broader look at civil society to realize our agenda. We have a duty to engage other donors, to invest more in MSM and transgender work. We should look, I guess, at the human rights movement. We could look at the achievements of the women's movement. There is a common agenda there based on principles of human dignity. And that agenda should and could be developed for the advancement of the sexual emancipation of all people, regardless of their sexual propensities or gender identity. But there are also other institutions out there who can become involved, and they are maybe less obvious. I'm talking about knowledge networks, about schools, universities, and why not? Microcredit institutions. Why shouldn't microcredit schemes not provide new opportunities for gay men and transgender people for earning income instead of being forced of going into sex work? Wouldn't this decrease their vulnerability to HIV and boost their self-respect? And I could go on. What about linking with faith-based organizations, with religious institutions, or with the corporate sector? And why not the sports sector? I'm sure that all of you, I was one of the few who did not, because I don't like soccer, but I'm sure that all of you enjoyed the last few weeks the World Championship. And I suppose we could say that the winning World Cup team last Sunday might produce some great role models to support our fight. And we will never know unless we really try and engage them. So there's another thing for the agenda, I guess. With the recommendations of the policy brief, social discrimination in hand, I would like to encourage the Global Forum and the regional MSM and HIV networks, such as EPCOM, AMSHER, and ASICAL, and they have been mentioned as well, to really pursue this alliance strategy. For example, organize roundtables in Africa, Asia, and Latin America. HIVOS will facilitate that work. Be sure of that. So let's bring together all kinds of actors, not just the usual suspects, and push them into translating these recommendations into concrete action. Of course, with respect and regard for the local context. I do think that this is really one of the most important roles of these networks. And that's why advocacy organizations like yours are so important. And APCOM's last year's work, I don't know where is Shiv, but I'm sure he's around there. There you go. Your work in this respect was really a great example to us all. And I hope that that example can be followed. So let that be a start. Others should be welcome to join and take the initiative further. And I can tell you again, and forgive me for keeping talking about HIVOS, but we are proud of what we've been doing. You can count on HIVOS. We have been supporting all these organizations and networks I've just mentioned, and HIVOS is also engaging with the country coordinating mechanisms and the Global Fund to ensure that active participation of MSM and transgender groups in the CCMs is ensured. I am proud to say that in the last 2 years, about 16 organizations supported by HIVOS have become members of CCMs. So I do think that there is already, as was mentioned by Michelle, some work being done there. I would like to conclude by saying, be heard. Yes, but also be loud. Don't let society and the establishment push you aside. Stand up, be visible, and claim those human rights. There's a great potential of activists and professionals on MSM and HIV here today. This is an incredible opportunity. And you know that HIVOS is committed, a committed ally. So together, we can fight the common battle against HIV and against homophobia, against transphobia, against poverty, prejudices, fear, and hate. Yes, we can. Remember that. I wish you all a successful and inspiring day and conference. Thank you very much.